just off of the beaten path, a little dot on a state road map. That's where I was born and where I'll die. Things move at a slower pace. Nobody's in the...
Our extension agent in our office is a resource that we just couldn't do without here on Robert's Family Farm. Well, in 2000, we started Robert's Family Farm, and we wanted to do something completely different than anybody else in the area. When we started fresh with the pumpkins, just not knowing anything what to do, and then we, after a few years, we went into no-tilling the pumpkins, and that was something they helped us with. Andy found out about that, and we did some research on it, and now we plant all our pumpkins with a two-row no-till tobacco setter, and it's so much better now that we've got something for the pumpkins to grow on instead of on. They don't get all the Z's they used to have. Andy Mills, our local extension agent, really helped us with that, helping us with our chemicals on all of our produce, because not a lot of people in this area do that. I was into a fungicide program, got me into a insecticide program. University of Kentucky used us as a guinea pig. We were one of like 12 farms to get into blackberry production. And now the blackberries are really a good thing for us because we are selling to everybody here locally, our farmer's market. And we've also got two wineries we're selling to. And you can get a lot of things off the internet, but when you really need help and it comes down to the bare tacks, you know, calling Andy or Jennifer or Carol or anybody in the office down there. Been a great resource for us, helped us advertise, helped us find co-op money we didn't even know was out there, so that's been a good thing for us.
Without 4-H, I wouldn't be the person I am today. With all the leadership and communication and networking and everything that it's taught me, I would probably be sitting in the on the couch, not moving forward. 4-H has taught me many skills through all the programs they have, like leadership skills. I've learned so much through team conference and state team council and teen summit that I've been to, and I couldn't be able to use that in the future. More youth should be involved in 4-H because it's just a great opportunity. It teaches you so much, and it's got so many opportunities for anyone's personality, like sewing, or you can show animals. There's some military programs in many counties. There's just all kinds of stuff. It's benefited me through giving me more leadership skills to persuade more opportunities in the future so that I can be successful. And because of it, I have goals that I can move forward to and accomplish in the future.
Jennifer Bridges has been instrumental in sending me artisans here of all types of artwork, between woodworking, quilts, sewing, painting. I had a gentleman, Russ Fackler, who does an awesome job with horseshoes. He makes all kinds of variety of different signs, personalized names, welcome, just unique items made out of horseshoes. With Jennifer, she has referred us to many farmers, local farmers here, and also across the state, who have helped us with our Kentucky Proud menu that we have here. We also have brought in Kentucky Proud food to resale. So she's been very instrumental in that. One local farmer she referred to us, and we've also met him at the farmer's market, is Ed Pike, Ed and Mary Pike, and we use their ground beef here at our shop in the Lick Skillet Cafe, and it's just a wonderful burger. Her sending us artisans and just the quality of the artisans have been just enormous for us. Of course, it all, if I can show them work, show the work with different artisans, it definitely has made an impact because there's such a variety here. Jennifer has been very instrumental in directing us in different avenues, what we need for our business, especially with the farmers market and the different farmers. And also with the artisans, she's helped us tremendously, but she's also got us in contact with different people that can help small businesses like myself.
It's been a valuable resource. I pester Andy every day to get advice on different crops, and all the classes I've attended have been a big help, and I've attended a lot. So went through the Master Cattlemen's with them. That was a big help. They have guest speakers at the Master Cattlemen's meetings. Those are always informational. Just this spring on the head scab in the wheat, when I found it, I didn't have a clue what it was. Took it to you and Andy, and y'all gave me an answer real quick. Of course, it was too late to do anything about it then, but at least I know for the next year, so we keep learning.
I was raised up in the extension program in Western Kentucky. I started in 4-H. I was a teen leader, an adult leader, and after college, I came to Meade County as a 4-H agent. Worked with many kids. I started in 1988, I became the ag agent, and then after my son was born and I was expecting Lydia, I decided to stay home with my kids. My kids have both come up through 4-H. They both started in clover buds, showing livestock. They've both done speaking contests, all the different activities, which I credit that to the way my kids have turned out. They've met many kids throughout the state that have helped them. They stay in contact with a large number of them now. I can't talk about how much 4-H means to me. I think that it builds character. I think it helps the contest we have help these kids. I really am a promoter of it, and I think that all kids should try to be involved. There's something for everybody. Extension to me is just a part of life here on the farm.
My mother and my grandmother, both grandmothers, were charter members of the Homemakers Clubs in Adair County. And so I went to homemakers meetings. As I got older, I joined 4-H. And with 4-H, I did a lot of different projects. This was what influenced me to become a family and consumer science teacher as a career. Extension service helped a great deal in my teaching years also. We would have people from the Extension service come in and speak to the young people. I know that Extension Homemakers and Extension is an educational program, but you also develop in a lot of other ways as well as just through the education. And I think when you work with people and you see people, that's a part of education too. It's kind of an outreach. And it has been incorporated so much into my life that it's kind of hard sometimes to divide where my college education began and where my extension education began. Extension has been a big part of my life. And I'm sure for an example, last week, my grandson decided he wanted to make strawberry jam. And so it had been a while since I'd made strawberry jam, and I couldn't put my hand on what I had used before, recipes and so forth. So we went to the extension office, and we got some leaflets. And so he came home and read those in order to make his strawberry jam to enter in the Meade County Fair. To know where I can go to look for information, and that's been something that I have tried to pass on to other homemakers and to other people, that you can go to the Extension Service and that you can get a wealth of information there.
Down home, where they know you by name and treat you like family. Down home, a man's good word and a handshake are all you need. Folks know if they're falling on hard times, they can fall back. In the corner of the hardware store, gathered round a checkerboard.